Everyone, thank you so much for joining me back here on my channel. Please don't mind me, I'm just all over the place. I went and I filmed, I got undressed, I had tea, I was chilling, living my best life. And then the minute I sat down to edit, I'm like, girl, you forgot an introduction. So here's your introduction. For today's tutorial, I am going to show you how you can manipulate your full coverage foundations to look more natural, feel more lightweight, and look more like your skin's texture. Kind of like, you know, you woke up like this, but with like the most intense beauty filter ever. Without it looking cakey, feeling heavy, or just being straight up full coverage foundation. I don't know how else to explain this, but basically I'm just going to show you some tips and tricks that I have learned from like my trainers and my experience working at MAC and like Fashion Week and backstage and all of that, to show you how you can manipulate your full coverage foundation to do what you want it to do. So if you're keen to watch, head on straight into the video. If not, maybe next week will be better. That's all I can say. So enjoy and let's get straight into the video. Okay, so let's get started. I obviously have already got like my eyes on, pretty eyes, and I've done skincare. Skincare is super important before doing any kind of makeup because it helps obviously to like prep your skin and all that. So I've cleaned my face, I've exfoliated, I've done my serums, my eye creams, moisturizers, sunscreen, and yeah, so I've done all of that already. So just to let you know, that is an important step in getting a flawless face foundation. You know what I'm saying? Okay, moving on. I'm gonna use all that I've kind of learned there and show you that here. I'm gonna try and keep it short this time because my last two videos were cringeworthily long. Okay, so first and foremost, the thing that we always got taught, or the thing that we start off with first that's super important, is working in product into the skin and making sure that all the prep work is before doing any like foundations and stuff like that. So the first thing that I would normally go in with first, always, is just to give the skin like a quick burst of hydration. So I'm gonna go in with my Fix Plus. This one is the scent Cherry Blossom, and it's from the Petal Power collection, which I think is still available. It should still be. So I'm just gonna give this skin a bit of a spritz. Now, you can use any setting spray or Fix Plus or whatever kind of instant hydration goodie that you have at home. Just go in with something just to give your skin a bit of a, I'm gonna wake. Kind of moment thing. Yeah, then the next thing would be your moisturizer. So you can go in, of course, with any moisturizer you want, absolutely anything, so long as you take the time to work in this moisturizer. Okay, so the moisturizer I'm going in with today focusing is my Clinique Moisture Surge Intense, because this the reason why I like this, wow, is because it is of a gel consistency, so it's fast absorbing, it's easy to work with, it's lightweight. Obviously for backstage that works, but I mean in your normal day-to-day, whatever you have, use it. Normally I would recommend that you work your moisturizers and things in with like a skincare brush or like a soft brush, so that there's like minimal dragging of the skin. But sometimes it is also really good to work with your hands, because then you can tell and you can feel where your skin is a little bit dry and needs like more moisture and stuff like that. So yeah, so just take your time and really massage your product in. Okay, so after you have like your moisturizer and stuff down, it's time to go in with a primer. So primer recommendations for when you want to manipulate a full coverage foundation is to go in with a primer, number one, that works in with your skin concerns. So if you want to like minimize your pores or like give your skin radiance, like find a primer that does that for you. But most importantly, to like really sheer down a full coverage foundation, my recommendation in terms of a primer should be something that gives your skin radiance or gives your skin like a glowy finish. Just things like that, because if you want to like sheer down a full coverage foundation, you can't go in with something that is like silicone-y. It needs to be a liquid primer. It can't be like of a gel consistency or a balm or I don't know, like a thick primer. It has to be something super liquidy so that you can mix everything in and then apply it on your face. Okay, cool. So my choice of primer for today, my Becca Backlight Priming Filter. Again, because I need a brush. The reason why I like this is because it gives the skin a really nice ethereal glow. It's not super heavy, it's not super metallic-y either. It's just gonna give the skin a really nice, healthy glow from within sort of look. And normally, especially for backstage, we would mix the foundation and the primers together, but I want to try something a little different today. So I'm going to be applying my primer first and then doing something else. So I'm taking this on a 188 Duo Fibre brush. This is really great for like buffing in product. And if you just kind of want to know a little bit more about brushes, I do have a video on all my favorite brushes and tools that I like to use, and that will come up here for you somewhere. Did you see it? Click on it.
After the video though.
Okay, after the video. We need to learn how to do our face first, you know what I'm saying? Cool, so again, with your primers, you can go in with your hands if you want to, but because this is quite metallic-y sort of finish primer, I don't want to get that on my hands, you know, just being clean. Okay, so I also just went ahead and opened up the curtain because I just felt like the light was fading on me, and it still looks like it's fading on me, so whatever. Okay, so now that we have a glowy sort of primer down, the next thing we're going to do is move into foundation. So normally when we were working backstage, the key foundations that we would use, keep in mind I was working for MAC, so obviously all the product had to be MAC. All the key foundations that we normally went in with were like your face and bodies and your waterways, because they were very sheer, very lightweight, very easy to work with and touch up on. The problem that we were faced with is when we had a model and we just didn't have their shade in a face and body or a water weight, the next thing you can do is turn to a more full coverage foundation and then sheer it out. So that's technically kind of the technique I'm trying to show you today, is how to take your full coverage foundation and make it more wearable. So the most full coverage foundation I have is the Studio Fix Fluid. Of course, this is not my shade. This is like NC negative something or the other. So I'm just gonna take like one of my decanted samples and use that. So this is NC15, which is a touch too dark for me, but the NC10 is too light. So you can see like I have a good sample. And the trick, or the hack if you will, that I learned while I was working backstage, is to either mix a primer in, if you want to do that, or to take an essential oil and sheer that out. So I have the Prep and Prime Essential Oils from MAC here. This is grapefruit and a chamomile, and I'm going to do a little drop of this into the foundation. So let me do that real quick. So I'm just gonna do like one squeeze. I'm not gonna use that much though, because that would be straight up oil and that's ridiculous. And then I'm just going to drop it into the cap here. So the trick, I'm only doing one drop because my nose is super oily and I just don't want to disrupt that. So the trick with this is to mix not more oil in ratio to your foundation, but to take less amount of your foundation that you would normally go in with, and mix in a little bit more of your primer. You can mix whatever you want. You can do your moisturizer, you can do your primer, you can do a liquid highlighter like this one. This is the Makeup Revolution liquid highlighter. You can literally mix anything you want into your foundation, so long as you don't use as much foundation as you would normally use just to apply foundation to your face. And don't go overboard with your mixing medium, so don't use more primer in comparison to your foundation, or more beauty oil, or whatever it is. Like, just keep your ratios like two-thirds to a third, two-thirds being your foundation, a third being whatever additive you want to add. Cool, so I'm just gonna mix that up real pretty in the lid here. And then I would normally suggest going in with a wet beauty sponge, but because my additive today is oil and water and oil don't mix, that sponge is not gonna work. So that's when I would go back in with a Duo Fibre Brush, specifically because this just blends out everything in a more natural sense. So it doesn't look, it will blend out the foundation or your new mixture fairly naturally, if that makes sense. So I'm just starting off with a little bit, and I'm holding my brush at the end so that there's a lot of blending give. And I'm literally working in circular motions, and I'm just buffing the product in. So of course this mixture is gonna be super glowy, super lightweight, but you're still gonna get the coverage from the foundation. So like I said, there are more full coverage foundations out there, but the most full coverage foundation I have on hand is the Studio Fix one. I feel like there should have been an ending to that point or that story, but I can't remember what I was actually trying to say. Okay, cool. So I'm just gonna stop there to show you. So you can see I definitely have more coverage on this side. Like, it does look more even out compared to this side. Like, the blemishes I have here are almost gone, but they're not entirely gone. This side just looks more even out, more dewy from the coverage of the foundation, but because we sheared it out, it still maintains that really pretty skin texture that we are trying to achieve. So that's pretty much the point of this whole thing, is just to show you what you can use to sheer out your full coverage foundation. The technique of applying it, buffing it in like this, or stippling it in, does have a result of a more, or does give the result of a more skin-like texture. It's more natural, it's not caked on, but you're still getting coverage. So yeah, so if you're a full coverage person but you still want like that really nice skin texture that we've got here, do this. My favorite mixture or formula that I loved to go in with is a little bit of strobe cream. A little bit of strobe cream, like the tiniest bit of essential oils, mix that together, put that on the skin first, and then drop the tiniest bit of Natural Radiance primer into the foundation, and then apply that. Like, that was just my solid proof, foolproof formula for when it came to like backstage skin. Of course, this doesn't feel heavy. I've barely used any foundation on my face. It doesn't feel heavy, it's very lightweight. It's still gonna give you longevity in your wear because it is a long wearing foundation. Full coverage foundations are a little bit more long wearing. So yeah, this is pretty much my skin with just foundation, or that foundation mixture, and my primer. So let's head on to concealer. So when we were backstage, again, the consensus when it came to concealers is very lightweight, very sheer, but still gave coverage. So we would normally go in with like a water weight concealer or the pro palettes. So this is just the first one I picked up, but these palettes, because they give coverage but they're super sheer. Personally, for me, my favorite was the water weight, but I can't wear that on my skin. It just agitates my skin for some reason. Don't know why, it's just not shan friendly. So my favorite thing is these Prep and Prime highlighting pens, because they brighten. Look, they don't conceal like scars and things, because that's not the job of this pen. This pen is to help brighten and to kind of conceal. It's a very, very sheer product. So I'm just gonna go over the areas that I feel need a little bit more coverage, but not really. This product is really good because it still mimics the texture of skin, like I said, because it's not super heavy and it brightens. So I like to go in to my inner corners here because they're looking super blue and bruisey. So normally what we did for fashion weeks and backstage and stuff like that is we would use color correctors where necessary, not always, only when necessary, and then go in with concealer. That was it, because the trick to editorial skin or backstage skin is to make it as perfect as possible, but to keep it looking super natural. So like this very perfected, just woke up like this human being, but in actual fact she had the most amount of makeup on, and you wouldn't even know. So I'm just gonna take my JH32 blending brush and I'm just going to blend out all the areas where I've placed this concealer. I let it sit for a bit because this is one thing I didn't know, and I heard my trainer explain this to me. She was saying that if you just leave this product on a little bit longer and don't blend it out straight away, it is going to just settle and thicken up slightly, which means that the consistency is just going to get a teensy bit more creamier. So if anyone here remembers the Studio Select cover up concealers, it was a concealer that came in a little baby tube, it looked like a lip gloss tube. That consistency was really creamy and really great for concealing. So this consistency, well, the consistency of this highlighting pen mimics that, and that's why I really like it, because that was my favorite concealer before it got discontinued. So as you can see, I'm not swiping, I'm pushing it in first, and then whatever's just left on my brush is what I'll use to just kind of gently buff it in, buff it out, swirl it around. So you can see I've still maintained a really nice skin texture. It still looks super glowy, super natural, just woke up like this kind of thing, but it looks more perfected, and that is the point. That is why we are here. Okay, so we're back. I just finished up underneath the eyes, put more mascara on, and just brushed a gel through my brows because we're not here for that. So, obviously not everyone has super great skin. Some people have really, really oily skin, and there are still areas that they want to like matte down so they don't have, like for me, I have a super oily nose. It's so gross. So I would matte down my nose area because I know makeup moves and just gets destroyed throughout the day around my nose. I have a really bad scar that takes up like half my face. And normally if I have any glowy product around my scar, it looks terrible. So I normally matte down these areas here. My chin, because my chin with me doing this throughout the day moves. So you want to obviously hotspot, and basically what hotspotting means is that you take a very precise brush like this, or a really just soft powder brush, and just only with a loose powder or a pressed powder, whatever you want to do, only just matte down certain areas so that you're still giving the skin dimension, because now you're mixing texture, so you have like this really glossy skin against a super matte area, because you know texture is more visually appealing. And just go in and mattify certain areas that look very oily, that will come up super shiny on like a catwalk or a photo or just during the day, like wherever you may be. But you don't mattify the whole face, because then that defeats the purpose. So I'm gonna go in with some translucent powder. This is my MAC loose powder. And I'm just gonna keep with the same JH32 brush. I'm just gonna pick up a little bit and like tap off the excess. This is a super finely milled powder, and the reason why I really like using this powder is because it does give the skin a really nice filter effect. So it does make the area in which you apply the powder more flawless, and I don't want to say flat, flat's not the word. It just makes the skin look really smooth. So even though you are mattifying down certain areas, it's not going to take away from the skin's pretty looking goodness. I need to learn how to describe what I'm doing better. I feel like I've forgotten how to do this. Anyway, so like I said, I tend to get super oily around my nose, but I really like this glossy gleam that's at the top here, so I'm not going to touch that. And you will notice I'm taking my time and I'm pressing the powder in. I'm not swiping anything, because if you do that, you're just going to pick up what you put down and then that's kind of wasteful. So I'm just mattifying just across my bridge here. And the tiniest bit on the tip, just because that's just normally where my makeup disappears on my skin. In between the brows here. And just lightly across the forehead, because sometimes if that area does come up super shiny, it can just give the overall illusion that the skin is super oily, and that's not pretty. Just a little bit down the chin here, because that's just where makeup disappears for me. And then I'm just going to go in and just set where I did place that concealer, just so that it doesn't move. And I'm keeping it super tight up underneath my eyes so that we still have this nice glossy look on the cheeks. So really, hot spotting mainly just pertains to like the center of the face, but you're not taking away from the overall skin's texture, and that's kind of the point. You want to keep it natural but pretty. Okay, so that's pretty much how you can manipulate your full coverage foundation to look super natural and glowy and just more like your skin. Of course, obviously, if you want your skin to look matte and you don't like this glowy texture, then by all means go in with a powder. But if you really like this dewy look but you just want that full coverage effect, this is how you do it. Of course, obviously, you can go in now with your bronzers and your blushes and your highlighters and all that jazz, but essentially this is just how we got really good skin. This is how I got taught to manipulate a full coverage foundation, and I've been doing it literally ever since I learned that trick. Okay, so that's pretty much it. All I added was a little bit of highlighter just to obviously emphasize the glow that I have on my skin. I didn't go crazy all over the place. I literally just hit the super high points of the face, a little bit of bronzer, nothing too intense, and then some gloss to actually, and then a little bit of gloss just to add some texture back in, because everything was super glowy and then my eyes are like kind of matte. So I hope you really enjoyed this tutorial. It's super easy. I hope you understand now how you can make the most out of your full coverage foundations. You can obviously wear it super light like this, or build it up a little bit more using the same method, or just go straight in with your full coverage foundation and live your full coverage fantasy. Super, super easy. Thank you so much for watching today's tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe and hit the notification bell, and I will see you in my next video.